Today I'm going to show you how you can use TradingView. I will show you everything around and how TradingView works and what features TradingView offers. And to my opinion, guys, TradingView is the best charting tool out there. Not to mention that this is also a social platform for traders, where traders can follow each other, where you, for example, if you have an account here on TradingView, you can create your own charts, you can save your charts, and this is absolutely for free. There is also a paid options, but these options you will not need if you are not in trading for at least 1 year. So TradingView is very friendly for beginners and for new traders. You will have everything what you need. You will be able to find cryptocurrency pairs, you will be able to find market movers, which I will show you how to find and see in this video. First thing, if you are just starting out, guys, I would recommend you to create account, because this is, like I mentioned, absolutely free on TradingView, and you can simply create account and you will be able to save your charts which you are working with. And why would you even need to save a charts, you might ask, or if you are a new trader or you are a new into trading, guys? You might need to save charts to make your predictions whenever you are drawing different lines by using different tools on charting tool. This is for your prediction. For example, you think that price will go up and you check your indicators, for example, and you draw a chart and you want to see how it performed from the chart you have drawn. But let's go step by step and let's start with charting tool. First thing, like I mentioned, I would recommend anyone who is new to TradingView. You will see the first screen like this when you will come in into TradingView, and here you will see a lot of different charts which are drawn by community, Crypto Guts, Crypto Bullet, and William Lockhart, and BotJ11, and so on and so forth. These are all people who are using TradingView and they are sharing their predictions here on TradingView. You can follow these people, so as if you start drawing your charts, someone is able to follow you as well and watch what is your prediction. So if you are following some asset or asset class or some stocks or anything at all which is related into trade. So first, guys, is join free. As you see, there is the button, and come in and join free, and you can join easily by using your Google, just by clicking this, or your Twitter or Facebook. I will not be joining as I already have account, but I think that this is fairly simple for anyone who is interested to come in and join TradingView. Here is the first button, which is ideas, and this is from the community of TradingView, where you can find different ideas on different asset classes or on different financial instruments, you can call them. As you can see, asset classes, cryptocurrencies, currencies, stocks, indices, futures, bonds, CFDs, and so on and so forth. Second button which you will find here is markets, where you can find different markets on different asset classes, like currencies. This is like forex markets, where you can find different currency pairs. Then we have stocks, and on stocks, if you are hover over, you can see here large cap stocks, top gainers. If we click into top gainers, you will see the top stocks which have gained in the recent 24 hours prices. TWMC, it has gained 50%. Next one is CLDX, it has gained 35%. So if you would be investing in these stocks, you would be making 50% or 35%, and there is many more stocks. So these are the best performing stocks. If we go back now and we go into markets, we again go into stocks, and the same way you can see here, top losers, we have most active, most volatile, overbought, oversold, all-time high, and overbought, oversold. If you are new to markets or stock markets or to trading in general, guys, this is also important information, because if stock is overbought, you might consider selling it because its price might go down. These are two very important indicators. When stock is overbought or oversold, you might consider buying or selling stock, but this is also information which I will be sharing with you a little bit later. Then we have all-time high and all-time low stocks, the highest and lowest price for particular stocks, which you can also find the list here on TradingView. Then we have scripts, and scripts are for different indicators which are created, for example, by some community, and most of indicators on TradingView you can get and use for free. However, there is also indicators which you can access only if you are a member of TradingView, so you will have to upgrade to a trading plan. Then we have screeners, different screeners, forex screener, crypto screener, and stock screener, then brokers. Brokers we don't need because there is never really a good information in brokers. There is one, two brokers listed. I believe that these are sponsored listings by TradingView. So just ignore this part. And then we have charts where you can open chart, guys, or where you can open chart in general. So now let's close this, and I will assume that you have logged in. As you can see, here is my profile. I have logged in, and if I click here on TechWolf, I go into my profile. This is how my profile looks, where in my profile I can see my reputation. This means that if I have been creating charts, guys, I would have reputation here, which is coming a feedback from community. Then here would be ideas, how many charts I have been sharing, and so on and so forth. Then I have scripts. For example, if I have created some scripts for indicators, they would appear how many scripts I have created, and they would be here. Then there is likes, how many people have liked my profile, and followers, how many people are following what I'm doing, my charts and what I'm charting. Then we have ideas, scripts, followers, following settings. This is also pretty much here, where in settings you can find your settings, where you can add a link to your website, where you can write about your bio, and so on and so forth. Everything pretty much the same as in other social networking platforms. Now let's go to TradingView itself. If we click here in TradingView or TradingView logo, guys, you will get redirected back to TradingView main page, how you would be able to find some assets. And let's start with Bitcoin. For example, if I would want to find a Bitcoin and United States dollar pair, one option is by start typing here in search. I will type BTC USD. And it will open me all markets and all pairs which are related to BTC USD. Here on the right hand side, you will see exchanges. As you can see, these yellow ones, these are exchanges. Those are the charts from those exchanges. Here you in the middle will find pairs like BTC USD, and this is in BitBuy exchange. What I'm using mostly when I'm looking at Bitcoin USD pair, I'm using Coinbase exchange. So I'm looking BTC USD in Coinbase. So I want to open this chart here. Whenever you are typing in a pair BTC USD, not shorts and longs, this is totally different. This is like if you want to preview short, how many shorts are in Bitcoin in this particular exchange, which is Bittrex, or how many longs are in this particular exchange, which is also Bittrex, you would click here. But this is not the price chart, so make sure that there is no longs, no shorts, and no futures behind this currency pair. As you can see here, guys, we have BTC USD, and this is in BitBay, but we are looking in Coinbase. So BTC USD pair and in Coinbase, so click in this one, and this will open Bitcoin United States dollar chart. There is another way how you can open charts, but just by clicking chart first and then type in a currency pair, but I am just showing you now from this screen. And as you can see, guys, we open this chart, but if I would want to open it in separate window, here you will see full featured chart on the top right corner. Just click on that and it will open you the same chart in the full window. So you can start charting, you can have a look in a view of full screen how this chart looks. This is your chart, and this chart is in candlestick. Red one is when the price was going down, and the green one is when the price was going up. But about candlesticks and how they work and candlestick patterns, we will be also talking in one of my future videos. This is just to give you a basic understanding to wrap your head around TradingView and what is going on here, so you can start working with this tool. Then here on the right hand side you see the price, and the second line which is green here, you can see whether market is bullish. This means that there is more buyers in the market than sellers, or whether the market is bearish. And bearish means that this wouldn't be green, but it would be red here on TradingView. This means that there is more sellers. This means that there is a huge selling pressure, and there are more people selling than there are buying. To scroll mouse forward, it will expand chart. To scroll mouse backwards, it will make the chart back. Here on the left top corner, you will see D. This is the time frame. Currently, each candle represents 1 day. If we will click here, you can change here in this drop down other time. For example, if you would want to represent 5 minutes. So let's click on it, and now each candle represents 5 minutes. And if you would like to, for example, preview another asset, as you can see here on the left top corner, you see Bitcoin USD pair. if you would want to see another asset, let's say Tesla, one option is by clicking in here at Bitcoin USD, it will open and you can start typing in, for example, Tesla or whatever. TSL, you will see, you can guess pretty much Tesla, it will give you Tesla stock price. If you click here, guys, it will give you a Tesla Inc. As you can see here, guys, if I click into there, you will see a Tesla stock price is currently $901. And another option how you can search searching, let's search for example for Bitcoin USD pair to get back to our chart. You can simply start typing BTC. As you can see, when you start typing, you are seeing that it will automatically start searching. You don't need to click even anywhere. BTC space USD, for example. Here you can see that we have this crypto BitBay and I am going with Coinbase. So I will go Bitcoin USD with Coinbase and I click here again, guys. So search is also fairly simple with TradingView. Next thing is that at the very top you will find these other buttons which are different indicators which you can use, but here on the left hand side you will find a toolbar. These are different tools which you can use to draw on your charts or which you can use to mark your chart. Well, first one here is, this is how your cursor looks. As you can see, in my case it's cross. If I would want to change it for arrow, for example, I would click this and it would, my cursor would look like arrow. Mostly I am preferred, for example, to use cross, so I click there and my cursor is like cross. Second here on the left hand side allows you to draw different lines. And note, guys, that if you click on these, if you hover all these tools, you can click on them. Here is one more small arrow, it will give you more tools in that particular category. For example, here in arrows we have trend line, info line, trend angle, horizontal line. Let's use horizontal line. If you would want to use anywhere horizontal line to mark just on your chart, guys, you click here a horizontal line and then you can draw a line. Just click, and if you want to draw another line, again click on horizontal line, and here on top you can also draw a horizontal line. And this is very good tool, for example, for drawing trend lines. And we will talk about how to draw trend lines also in one of my future videos. For example, here is another trend line. If we would want to draw, let's say, let's draw trend here, one trend line, let's say here it starts, and you can decide where it will end. Once you are happy, guys, you just click again and this is your one trend line. And if you would want to draw another one, you just start it there and you can start draw it there, like, and this would be your trend line. And to revert actions, you can use Control Z on your keyboard and it will remove everything what you have drawn just by Control Z if you don't need it or if you have changed your mind. And here is another tool which is Pitchfork currently, but there is also lots of different tools, and one of most famous ones which you probably already know is Fibonacci retracement tool, which allows you to draw Fibonacci retracement. And we will talk about what is Fibonacci retracement also in one of my future videos, and about all these numbers, what they mean in this tool. So Control Z, and there is many more tools which you can come and which you can use. For example, icons are very useful. For example, if you would want arrow icon, which where you would want to point something out, for example, on your chart and say that this was the lowest point, and you can also leave different and notes on your chart while you are charting. There is plenty other icons, guys. Then there is measurement tool, and this is very useful if you would want to, for example, measure how much price has been changed. Here on the top we can mark very top, we can go to the very bottom. As you can see here, guys, we can see that their price have fallen from this top point to this lower point. Difference in price is 1.85%, and bars, 62 bars. This means that this currently include 62 bars, but you can make it as much as you want. All these things separately we will talk in my future videos, guys. So Control Z, we don't need this. So yes, guys, there is many more things which you can use here, but now let's talk about indicators. I will show you where you can find indicators. As you can see here on the top, there is indicators tab. If you click into these indicators, and I will be covering different indicators, but today we will have a look at RSI, or relative strength index. This is relative strength index. Just check it and you will see that that indicator appeared down here on the screen, guys. And what relative strength index means? This means that you can find whether the particular asset have been overbought or oversold. When price is higher than 70%, what is obviously happened, then it was oversold. Then we already talked about time frames. This means that each candle represents whatever time frame you are using. Currently we are using 5-minute time frame. This means that each candle represents what has happened in 5 minutes. But here, if you would want, for example, to go to 30 seconds, you will not be able to do it. Second time intervals, the second interval is available only for premium users. So these are those differences, guys, that what premium user can use and free account can't use. We will not be able to use these very fast time changes, what is happening here. But we can use 5-minute time frame with no problem and see what has happened in 5 minutes. This last candle represents what is happening at the last 5 minutes. And if you hover over candle, you can see 23rd February at the very bottom, 20s and 14:15. This means that this is happening right now. And next time candle will be 14:20. So this will represent next 5 minutes. And if you next after that will be 14:25. If you would want to change time frame, it is you could go for 1 hour. And now currently every candlestick represents 1 hour. So this one last one is 14. Before one was 13, and before that one was 12, as you can see below the chart, guys. These are different time frames which allow you to see what is happening. And smaller time frames are usually used by day traders or by scalpers who are scalping the markets. And what does it mean? We will also talk in my videos. Huger time frames mostly are used by long-term investors or by swing traders who are trading swing changes in prices or swings in prices. You can call it however you want, guys. Next one is different candles, but the only and the most popular are these candles which you are seeing right now on the screen, and this is used by many traders. There is also bars. Bars are used mostly, or if they are used, they are used by forex traders. Then we have hollow candles. This is another one. Then we have Heikin Ashi candles. Then we have line candles. Like this pretty much only represents your line, and many more things. But like I said, the most popular ones for traders, for stroke traders, are these simple candles which you see right now. And there is also a candle patterns which we will also be covering in my future videos. I would recommend you to just come in and have a look around and get a feeling of this TradingView charting tool, because this is fairly simple. After, when you will start charting, when you will start watching people videos or my videos where I will be showing you different indicators, for example, we could add another indicator, price trend indicator. You would see that we are having now two indicators. We have price trade indicator and we have RSI indicator, or relative strength index indicator. You can remove indicator by just hovering it over and you will see this cross sign. Just remove it or delete it and find another indicators. And another difference between premium accounts and free accounts is, guys, that as a free account you can't use more than 3 indicators on your screen. For example, if you would be using RSI and you would be using 2 more indicators, that would be your maximum. You wouldn't be able to use more indicators. This is pretty much it what I wanted to cover in this video. Have a look, play around. Believe me, you will get your head around TradingView tool. The more you will be using it, the more you will be looking at different videos or reading different books and trying out different indicators and doing more drawing. And we will also be doing it in my future videos. If you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing and see you in my videos.